Somebody. What happened? Okay.
What the hell?
I'm trying to.
Assalamu alaikum. Peace be upon you all. and welcome you here to the wedding of our dear brother and sister. And this wedding is a wedding with or between Muslims and Christians. And we would say Muslims and Christians because we're all a part of this ceremony. And it's our tradition in the ceremony to use the Arabic language as well as English language. We want to begin with the opening prayer. And this prayer you will find, as we said in Arabic and English, is a prayer that we all can accept regardless of our faith and regardless of our tradition. So we'll begin with this prayer. It begins in the Arabic language. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين English of this prayer is with the name of God, the merciful benefactor, the merciful redeemer. The praise belongs to God, the Lord of all the worlds, the merciful benefactor, the merciful redeemer, master of the day of judgment. Thee alone do we worship, and thee alone do we seek out for help. Guide us to the straight way, the way of those whom you have favored, not those who have received your wrath, nor those who have gone astray. Amen. Amen. In the first part of our ceremony, we would like to have a reading from the Quran and make some remarks concerning the wedding from this reading. God says to us in the Quran, he begins by saying, O mankind, and God is addressing all of us. This is the Quran, but it's saying, O mankind. It's not saying, O Muslim. It's not saying, O Christian, O Jew. Because what we find here is something that's common to all of us, regardless of our background. And this ceremony, this event, this special event, this special occasion, in the last of these two, we find it's common amongst all of us. So we're addressing everyone in this commonality. O mankind, be conscious of your Lord, who created you from one person. Who created you from one person. That we're to be conscious that we didn't get here on our own. That someone greater than us, outside of us, created us and brought us here as a single person. And from this single person, it's made. So we have two single persons today coming together. Amen. We have Nate as a single person who has found his mate, and we have Lisa as a single person who has found her mate. And they're both single, and they're mates of each other. And from the two of them, he has spread it countless men and women. That we started off with one here and one here. We bring these two together, and from the two of them, we have countless men and women. We have her family from her side, Christian and what have you. And we have from his side, Muslims and what have you. And just as we're tying these two together, we're tying these two families together. We have friends, we have relatives, and we can go on and on. And just from the tying of these two, we're bringing many, countless men and women together. But we started with just one. And God continues to say, and be conscious of God, who you seek your mutual rights. You demand your mutual rights. See, in this marriage ceremony, that both And we know, those of us who have been married for a while, both sides gonna be seeking their rights. She's gonna want her rights, and he want his rights. And God is telling us to be conscious of God as the two of you do so. This will help the marriage. And we all know it will help the marriage. Because the common rights and all rights come from God anyway. And be conscious of God. Be truthful to each other. Have faith between each other. Have trust between each other. Give. Be charitable between each other. These are all the first rights of anyone who believes in God. And think about God often between the two of you. And also, just as you are conscious of God, be conscious of the relatives. The same consciousness that you give to God, you should give that same conscience to each other's relatives. And it also says, and be conscious of the wounds that bore you. Meaning, be more conscious of your mothers, of the mother, and of the woman than you are of the others. If you were to ask, who is more honored, your father or your mother, the response should be your mother. And after that, who should we honor more? And the response is your mother. Then after that, who should we honor? And the response is your mother. And after that, then we honor the father.
What the heck?
Ladies, that's where you go in the house. The father's the last one to know. So, let us be conscious, because it is from our relatives that we have grown, it's from our relatives that we have developed, it's from our relatives, our associations, and our family that we have learned our ways. And the two of you coming together is not going to be so easy, bringing two people together, because you're bringing two backgrounds together. It goes a long way back, genetically as well as socially. So be conscious of all of this in your marriage, because these are the most important things. The other things you're gonna find are small. The food is burnt, the toast is burnt, you know, the car won't start. These are small things. Keep your mind on the bigger things, and the small things will take care of themselves. And God is greater than all. So with that, we would like at this time to exchange the vows. We will begin with Nathaniel Ibn Banks, and we will ask, Nathaniel, do you accept Lisa as your wife to live in accordance with what God has commanded? He said, he does. And we will ask Lisa, do you accept Nate as your husband to live in accordance to what you understand to be God's way?
Yes, I do.
And she says she does. Now, just as all of us are witness here to these two being married, it's a duty upon us to be witnesses that they stay married. This is our reason for being here. With that, we will have the exchange of the rings. Thank you. Now, just as Nathaniel and Lisa stands here holding the rings, we want to explain a little bit about the rings. This may not be traditional with all of us, but God tells us in the reading that the man is a garment for the woman, and the woman is a garment for the man. The man is the clothes for the woman, and the woman is the clothes for the man. So let these rings symbolize that we're going to take a strand from this garment, and we're going to take a strand from this garment. And the rings is symbolizing the tying of these two strands from each garment. And let us remember, if she pulls, you push. And if he push, you pull. But whatever you do, do not break the string. Noah, unravel the garments. And with that, I pronounce you man and wife. And I present to you all Mr. and Mrs. Banks.
Y'all coming on me too fast. The camera's running. Y'all moving on me too fast. I'll be there on the car.
Congratulations, Ms. Payne.
Which way y'all going?
Yeah.
right?
Thank you.
Oh, shit. I did my best. Don't worry about the tape.
Yeah, I wanted to get a picture of you and Nate. I wanted to get a picture of Nate and the guy by himself. I wanted to get a picture.
Yes, yes.
Second like picture
of our trash.
Okay, now the bridesmaid and
then what the other? Oh, yes.
What about Tammy? Tammy
Jim? Yeah, a lot of people missing. Oh, okay. Oh, here you go.
Jimmy, you better get up here.
Okay. Okay, maybe y'all can like tighten it up. Tighten it up, look, there you go.
Okay.
Hey, y'all both kind of like, yeah, kind of angle face her, like, but you can face the camera, but your body is. Yeah. All
right.
This is
fine.
Wow. I
She must be outside.
No.
She got a key to the Jeep.
I heard that.
Yeah.
Why didn't she sit in the Jeep?
Could be.
Who?
Apple. I don't know where she went to.
Nay, you got makeup.
Where?
Right here on your suit.
Okay, all three of y'all.
You haven't known anybody to film people coming out the top.
I was trying to wait on them two to come. It's on tape.
Get in the red truck.
Thank you. Okay, I'll close it. One second.